How's it going, YouTube? It's cold outside. Not too cold, but it's kind of cold. Should probably work on looking at my camera more than my phone screen. But still got Copenhagen Wintergreen. Got maybe two or three more pinches left in this can. And then I got a present. I got given a full can, not even cracked, of Copenhagen Mint. Sadly, it's not the camo can. I've never seen any Copenhagen Mint camo cans. Well, I've seen in pictures, but not, you know, in person. So, I'm just chilling out back behind my place here. Yeah, so I don't know what's up, but this will probably be a really short video because I have no idea what to talk about. Well, I don't know. I have no idea what I should talk about. Either way, you know, the fuck should I talk about? Hold on, let me pause. Think about that for a second. Got it. Didn't take me very long. Took me maybe 10 seconds to think about it. Maybe a little bit more than that. I have no idea. I've decided I'm going to do a video on the pros and cons of dipping. I may have already done a video on it. I have no idea. Let's put it on a bar. So, I'm going to go with either a pro for a con and go through the pros and the cons. No idea. Okay, I'll just do the pros and then the cons. So, say you've been smoking cigarettes for however long. We'll go with 10 years. Smoking cigarettes for 10 years. And say you just want to quit smoking because you can't, you know, maybe run or you've decided to do MMA or some shit. Or start playing a sport of some sort. And we'll say you're maybe 28. So you started when you're 18, you're 28 years old now. And you say you start working out or start doing MMA or some shit. And you can't run because you've been smoking for 10 years. But you still want nicotine. And you can't afford vape because vape is actually pretty expensive. So, the next best choice is dip. And it's a good thing for MMA fighters, because there's quite a few MMA fighters, you know, athletes that dip. Mostly because you get the nicotine, and it doesn't fuck up your lungs. The fuck are they doing down here? Okay, then. It's a college police from, like, 20 miles away. Why would they be here? Either way, probably here for the fucking... Oh, they're going to the hospital. Huh. No doubt. So, yeah, that's why a lot of athletes, MMA fighters, football players, baseball players, I don't know about basketball players. Most likely. But they dip, so you can get nicotine. And it doesn't affect your ability for running. If you're running with a dip in, then maybe. There's then, you know, might choke on spit or some shit. And another pro is it's a hell of a lot cheaper than cigarettes. Most dips are, anyway. Because where I live, anyway... Sorry, I was reading a message. Where I live, anyway, is... depending on the store, but it's all usually about the same. Is usually about $3.40 for Grizzly, and $3.60 for Copenhagen. The more expensive dips are Skoal and like Cope Original, Cope Snuff. Cope Snuff and Cope Original are about $4.50, about $5. And Skoal, I've only bought one can of Skoal. And that was Skoal Berry, because everyone was saying, like, it was fucking Skoal Berry is nasty as hell. It was okay. It wasn't horrible. Say you want like a sweet dip or something, then I would get Skullberry. Probably Copenhagen Straight. Because I don't want a dip that's overly sweet. Either way, I'm getting off topic here. Your breath usually smells better when you're dipping over cigarettes. Because all cigarettes usually smell the same. It makes you smell like a fucking ashtray. If you're dipping Skullberry, your breath will smell like berries. For the most part. Same thing with mint, wintergreen. You know. Those are the only really dips you can get away with smelling good. If you have a work, say you work in a factory or some shit, and they don't let you, you know, you want to be able to get your nicotine fix while you're working. And that's where dip comes in. Now, a lot of companies, shit, it's really fucking cold. But a lot of companies, factories and shit, don't usually let their workers dip long cut. So, god damn. Came from a long ways. It came from fucking Ann Arbor. Jesus. So if they don't let you dip long cut, that's where pouches come in. And those are really fucking good. Say you're in school and you want to dip. Pouches, there you go. You can fucking dip them some bitches in class. And you don't got to worry about fucking moving floaters around, making sure your dip's all in one piece. Well, it's technically not in one piece, but you know what I mean. So, you know, you dip pouches if you're working in a factory and they don't let you dip long cut. You just take them in, just take them out, throw them. I wouldn't necessarily throw them, you throw them in a trash can. Granted, you could do that with long cut, but, you know, they don't really give a shit. Can't think of any more pros. So on to the cons. There's really not many. Oh, another pro. A doctor, apparently a pretty prestigious doctor, said you could dip long cut, or just dip in general, and you have a hell of a lot less chance of getting cancer from it than cigarettes. He said a person that dips has just as much chance of getting cancer as someone who's never picked up a cigarette in their life. So, there's another pro. And, you know, people be like, oh, you're going to lose your teeth, you know. My grandpa's been dipping since he's my age, and his teeth are fine. And he's fucking almost 70. Actually, no, I think he's been dipping since he was maybe 10. So he's been dipping for a good 60-some years. Maybe 50-some years. Anyway, he's been dipping for a while. And his teeth are fine. So, and as long as you, you know, take care of your teeth, brush your teeth and shit, rinse out your mouth when you take out a pinch, you'll be fine. Now onto the cons, because this video is getting long, is, you know, if you get lucky and get a girl that doesn't really give a shit, you know, this one doesn't apply to you. But, you know, a lot of girls think dip is gross. Certain dips, yes. Like fucking Klondike. Shit's disgusting. But, I mean, that's not really a whole major thing. But, you know, if you dip, there's, you know, the thing you could do is really just not dip around her. Can't really think of anything else. I mean, yeah, your gums are going to recede, but that's not really, you know, too important. I asked my dentist about it. He said it's normal, it's fine. I mean, he said it's not really too serious, but if it starts getting, like, really low, then you should probably quit dipping. Yeah, other than that, I can't really think of any other cons. It's not bad, 2 to 5. 4. I don't know. But, there's that. I'm going to be doing a review an actual review, because I did a review on Cope Mint pouches. So once I finish off this can, which will probably be tonight or tomorrow, I'm going to do a review on Cope Mint. If I did a review on it before, and okay, I'm going to do another review on it. Unless I find someone else to make a video. And that video will be up sometime tomorrow. Either way, this video is going on too long. I just fucking realized I'm recording in another window. So, I'm going to end it here, and I will see you on the next video.